You know, there's a buzz phrase going around, DevSecOps. It is kind of just another buzzword. But I think what it is indicating is that the whole DevOps process we have, where we spend a lot of time automating things and making it as quick as possible for developers and operations people to get code out the door and to run it, what it is trying to do is to pull in the security concerns that are out there. Traditionally, security is a very manual process, a separate organization. It's hard to automate into your build chain. And that's a lot of what DevSecOps is trying to get to, is how do we make automating security as easy as it is to do configuration release management. A lot of what you want to do is make sure that you understand where a container has come from, how it's been built, and equally importantly, when you need to deploy a patch, that you can very rapidly fix those containers and redeploy them. I'm obviously biased, but from my perspective, having a very integrated, not only runtime environment, your Kubernetes environment, but also having a very integrated build process, I think is key to enabling that. When you have an integrated build process like that, you have a lot of control over how containers are built, what's in those containers, and as a security person, you can control those. And then on the other end of running it in production, and then putting the code in there to make sure you've deployed the right patch. So that's the first thing I would look at, is making sure that across the whole process of building your apps, you have control over what those containers are, what goes in them, and that you can very rapidly rebuild them without necessarily even having to bother the developers in production. So there's a good white paper from Forrester you can check out, and an interesting webinar we have. If you want to go to tanzutalk.com, you can find links to those, and you should check them out.